The last raid came on the 14th of August, 1945. And if you remember, the first atomic bomb was dropped August the 6th on Hiroshima. People thought there would be surrender. There wasn't any surrender. They waited 3 days, and on August the 9th, they sent out another atomic bomb. It did not hit the primary target because of weather, so Nagasaki got the second atomic bomb. Now, there was more people thinking there would be surrender, but there wasn't. The military was not about to surrender, and they waited 5 days. August the 14th, the largest raid ever went out to Japan. I have all the resumes of that raid. They total 809 B-29s airborne that day, striking 7 different targets in Japan. That raid brought the Imperial Council together for the first time since Pearl Harbor. The Imperial Council did not meet through the entire war after Pearl Harbor. But that raid brought the Imperial Council together, in tears, no less. And they sat together late into the night and finally came to an agreement that the emperor would make his talk the next day at noon on the 15th to his people. His people had never heard his voice, and they claim it was sort of high and metallic-like, but he did make his talk the next day at noon, and we had surrender. And guess where we were? The missions were long. 14 to 15 hours, we were still on our way back to Saipan. The radio operator, we had broadcast, could tune in broadcast station from Saipan or from Guam, and we learned that the war was over. The emperor had spoken, and we had surrender. The military did not get to take over the Imperial Council. And they managed to accomplish it along with the Empress. The Empress had a little bit to do with it also, and in the persuading of a surrender. We kept at our job. We still had that aircraft to get back to home base, but we felt relieved, quite a bit relieved, and got back to Saipan. Landed, taxied to the hard stand, which is the parking spot. They are called hard stands, where we turn the aircraft around, and the mechanics meet us there, glad to see us back, ready to jump on the aircraft to repair and service it. Not a soul there to meet us. Parked the aircraft, and the war was over. We knew the war was over. We knew that's why they weren't there. They were off celebrating, rejoicing over the end of the war. We secured our own aircraft and went and joined them in their rejoicing. That evening, there was a prayer service at our group. And the first weekend, first Sunday after surrender, a big church service out on the runway. We sat on the runway, the aircraft, the big B-29 sitting there with a cross in front of it, and even the propellers dressed for the occasion, all pulled into the same position by hand, and a platform in front of the aircraft with for the ministers and the singers. The wonderful service. And when I walked back to my hut from that service, it was a feeling of relief and rejoicing that only my God and I can understand, I think. I'll never forget it.
Now, when you look back